It's Tuesday, October 28th, 2008. I'm James Kotecki. Welcome to the show. Yesterday, Senator Ted Stevens of Alaska was found guilty on 7 felony counts for failing to report improper gifts. Now, a lesser senator would have resigned from office, limping off into the sunset with what little dignity he had left. But no doubt buoyed by the resilience of Senate colleagues who also faced down the criminal justice system, Ted Stevens is standing strong. He says he will remain a candidate for Senate. Stevens was already locked in a tight race with his Democratic opponent, Mark Begich. So the question is, how can Stevens possibly convince voters to reelect him now? Maybe he could make his appeal through some kind of hastily constructed series of tubes. Ah, that would never work. But say what you will about Alaskans, they certainly have a penchant for electing interesting people. Frankly, between Sarah Palin and Mike Gravel, I thought that Alaska had already injected more than its fair share of fun into the political madhouse we call campaign 2008. But now I know that when it comes to politics, the Alaskan magic runs deeper than the wells we could be drilling in Anwar. But Art.
The chant is drill, baby, drill.
Finally, folks, it's time once again to encourage some audience participation. Because frankly, you guys have been slacking off recently, leaving me to do most of the work around here myself. But as we all know, Halloween is fast approaching, and that means three things: costumes, pumpkins, and weird candy with razor blades in it. However you're planning to celebrate, intonation matters on this show, people, learn that. However you're planning to celebrate, I want to see it. So send your best politically themed Halloween pictures to jkotecki@politico.com. Are you carving Obama into your pumpkin? Are you hosting a haunted White House? Are you going trick-or-treating dressed as sexy John McCain? Well, I want to see pictures. Kind of. I'll feature the best and worst political Halloween pictures on Friday's video, and if you're the lucky grand prize winner, I will also personally haunt your dreams. Well, that's it for today's hit. Check out politico.com/Kotecki for more videos. And parents, don't worry about razor blades and oddly shaped pieces of candy. What you really have to worry about are brand name candy bars that have been injected through imperceptible holes in the wrapping with a deadly toxin that will melt off your child's flesh 5 days after he or she eats it. Happy Halloween from all of us here on Kotecki TV.